Okay, so what did we learn in the opener? Well, in the opener we said if A has the singular value decomposition U sigma V Hermitian transpose, where U and V are unitary matrices and sigma is this diagonal matrix with the singular values which are ordered from largest to smallest and are all non-negative. Now, if you form A Hermitian A, then what you notice is that its spectral decomposition is actually given by V sigma squared V Hermitian transpose. Okay? And if instead you form a Hermitian transpose, then its spectral decomposition is given by U sigma squared U Hermitian transpose. Now, typically our matrix A has many more rows than columns in a practical application. So probably forming H Hermitian transpose A is the better idea, because this is a square matrix that has size smaller than this matrix. This matrix is n by n, this matrix is m by m. Okay, what else? Well, this just tells you that if you have the singular value decomposition, then we can form the spectral decomposition of A Hermitian A. But that's actually not what we want to do here, because we have a method for computing the spectral decomposition of a matrix. We don't yet have a practical method for computing the singular value decomposition. So the better question is, if you were to form A Hermitian A and you computed its spectral decomposition, then how would you from that extract the singular value decomposition of matrix A? And, you know, we know this. Hey, we know what V is. Now, when we compute the spectral decomposition, it is not necessarily the case that the eigenvalues come out from largest to smallest. So we may have to put a permutation on our matrix sigma in order to make it have its entries ordered from largest to smallest. But once we have that, we can merely take the square root of the diagonal elements, and that would then give us our matrix sigma. In the process, it would also reorder the columns of matrix V. Now, once we have that, we know that A is equal to U sigma V Hermitian transpose. So what we can actually do is write A here and then bring V over here, and then sigma inverse over here. And what we notice is that all of that goes away, and we can actually compute U as the matrix A multiplied by V multiplied by the inverse of the diagonal matrix. Now, obviously, this gets a little bit hairy if some of the elements on the diagonal of sigma square are equal to zero, because then this is not actually a singular matrix, but let's not worry about that for now. Okay, so here we have a method where we compute A Hermitian A, we then compute a spectral decomposition, and then we use results from that spectral decomposition to come up with our unitary matrix U. There are actually problems with taking that approach. And why don't you think about what those problems might be, and then we'll discuss them in the next video.